What's Gucci, everybody? And today I am super excited to introduce my new merching series. Now, this is going to be a special merching series. It's going to be different from the typical 10 mil to 100 mil. And it's not going to be just a video tutorial on how to merch and all the different aspects that merching has to it. What I'm going to do is I'm going to combine the two. And this is going to be a 10 mil to max cape merching series because I'm almost max. I've got 2501 total level, and I did the calculations, and it will cost me about 250 mil without bonus XP to purchase all the buyable skills needed for max cape. So we're gonna do 10 mil to 250 mil, otherwise known as max cape for me. Now this is also, like I said, going to be a merching guide, and I'll have plenty of tips and examples all throughout it because I'm going to show you all the flips I'm doing, and I'm going to introduce you on how to do certain things. There's so many things to merching, but the primary thing people think of when they think of merching is flipping. So that's the first thing I'm going to introduce in this video. I'm going to show you the very basics of flipping and give you a few examples to what I'm doing to get us started. And then as we get farther into the series and as I acquire more revenue, I'll have more bank to demonstrate the other aspects of flipping and merching. So I can't wait to get started on all of that. So stay tuned. The guides will be appropriately labeled whenever I introduce something new, like some kind of investment or inactive flipping, things like that. I'll explain all that when I get there, of course. But for today, we're going to start with flipping and the basics of that. As you can see here, I'm just going to examine my coin pouch just so you know that there is, in fact, 10 mil exactly in my pouch. So let's get started in the grand exchange here. Now, the first thing I want to flip are my personal favorite things to flip with a low cash deck, and that would be Dragon Claws. Now, the first thing you need to know about flipping is it's very basic, it's simple, easy to do, a child could do it. So all you need to do is find two prices. The thing about flipping is it's buy low, sell high, essentially. And to do that, you need to know what kind of prices you should buy and sell for. So it's very easy to find those prices. All you need to do is put an offer for one of whatever item you're trying to flip in, and then boost that price up as much as you need. It's just to insta-buy the item. You want to insta-buy the item like I did here. Dragon Claws insta-bought for 1,448,999. Okay, so I'll remember that. Here, I'll even write it down here. Okay, now what you want to do is insta-sell the item. So I'm going to dump this a bit because that bought pretty low from the mid-price. Yes. Come on. And 1,403. Okay, so what you want to do now that you have your prices, you want to, like I said, buy low, sell high. So the price we just sold it for is the price you'll be buying it for. So I'm just going to put in an offer for as many as I can at 1,043K. Now, often what people do will be to bump up the price a bit. That's called overcutting. Or when they're selling it, they'll lower the price a few GP or a few K. That's called undercutting. Now, I don't like doing that simply because I can start overcutting and undercutting wars, really, and that's just unpleasant. That slows things down for everybody. So if you put it at the same price, that'll just share all the stock that's going into the GE with you and whoever else. Now, I left myself a little extra money just to do something else in the meantime. Let's just check back here. We see that the Dragon Claws are already starting to sell, and this is without overcutting, you see. We've already gotten two, and that's if we sell them for the the price we receive them for, which is 1.448, we'll already make about 45k profit on each one, which is 90k. And having started at 10 mil, that's pretty good for just the two. Now, we do have six extra in there. A little less pricey item. Let's check Ganodermic Flakes. I used to do these a lot. Am I just typing everything wrong today? Let's see. Ah, it's Flake. Okay, so 356 GP. Let's see if they're moving at all. I see my confirm offer button still hasn't changed. Okay, so 359 GP, they're pretty stable at the moment. Let's sell it back. Let me just note this down. Nine. And we get 350, okay. Now, what you need to know about flipping is you need to know the limit. Every item that can be traded has a limit. And what that means is that Jagex installed a trading limit on every item to prevent manipulation. So people can't buy, say, 5,000 Dragon Claws all at once and thus cause the price of them to skyrocket or drop depending on whatever price they bought them at. So every item, like I said, has their own limit. Dragon Claws, for example, have a limit of 10. Now, the limit is not daily. The limit only lasts 4 hours. So that means I can buy 4 Dragon Claws. I'm sorry, 10 Dragon Claws every 4 hours. Now, I can sell however many I want. The selling is not affected by the trading limit. Now, I just want to take a break here and say that all of my Dragon Claws, I bought all 6 of them. They bought fairly quickly then, so somebody must be trading them a little lower already, or the margin may have changed completely. But we're about to find out with the selling. I don't think that we're going to suffer too badly here. Let's just put them in. Eight. Okay. Now, I am undercutting a little bit here. I'm not trying to be mean with that. I just can't be asked to type in all the 9s. That's that guy's fault. The limit on Ganodermic Flakes is actually 28,000 per every 4 hours. And you can check this by going to the RS Wiki. I'll leave a link in the description if you want. They've got a huge long list of every item in RuneScape. Now, not every item has their limit because, you know, it's a Wikipedia page. So people enter when they find it, if they find it, and if they choose to enter. Now, I just did the math. If we buy all of these Ganodermic Flakes and sell them all at these margins, that would be about 250k profit. However, based on the amount of time it would take to purchase all 28,000 of those, I'm going to have to cancel on those. I'm going to skip out and choose something different. So another thing we can do, it's not as cheap, but let's look at whips. These are possibly one of the staple cheap flipping items in RuneScape. Their margin, their limit is 10 per 4 hours. 91k, wow, and mid price is 118k. These must be crashing substantially from their legacy rise, as I'm sure a lot of items are at the moment. I wonder what Armadillo Godswords are at. So let's sell this back. Now, usually the margin on whips are not the best, but that's simply because they're among some of the most traded items in RuneScape. Their volume is pretty high. So 85k, that's a 6k margin on each one. Now, normally I'd say, I don't really like that margin. However, based on the amount of cash we have and the fact that these flip so rapidly, I'm gonna go ahead and put in an offer for 9 of these because I've already bought 1, which means I have 9 left in these 4 hours. So let's put in an offer and we'll just wait on that. I have an extra 764k. So let me think. Okay, let's take a look at living minerals. These are also good to flip, and I looked at the graph fairly recently and saw that these were actually uptrending, meaning they were they've been going up for a long while now. So 309 of, and mid price is 326. Now, take into account that just because that your price check may be lower than the current medium price, that doesn't mean that the item is necessarily going to be crashing or that the price of the item for the next day will be lower than what it was today. That's simply the amount of money you price checked it for at that time. That's simply what people bought and sold that item for at that time. So it can be significantly different. You may have gotten an item lower sometime during the day, and later during the day, that item may be going for much higher. So I forgot the buy price. So 288 over 309. Okay, now I'm gonna check the limit on these because I don't wanna make an ass out of myself again. Okay, so now the margin of these, oh, I keep saying margin, the limit of these per 4 hours is 10,000. So we have 12, oh, math, that's 21 GP profit per living mineral, which is about 210K. So why don't we go ahead and stick in an offer for this? These are very commonly traded. So I am, I'm confident in their selling speed. Let's just put it in at 208, because if you put it in at 289, you'll almost always see that, oh, what am I doing? 288. You almost always see that somebody will just buy one to price check, and it's probably that person you overcut. And then you'll end up immediately regretting that, like I always do. So let's just put it in at 288. And now we're stuck for a little while. So I'll be right back when something buys or sells. A quick check up here. It's been about 3 to 4 minutes now, and all of the Abyssal Whips have bought. So I'm just gonna put them back in at 91K, simply because I don't remember the exact price. And as you can see, there's really no need to overcut and undercut, unless you see that it's taking just absolutely forever. I'd say over 20 minutes, 15, 20 minutes for small items like this. Larger items that we'll get into in much later videos, that you'll see that you have to wait a lot longer to be sure that they're just not going to sell. Now, the living minerals have also almost completely sold out to me, or bought, and they bought pretty quickly. I think there was one. Yeah, I had zero, and then all of a sudden I had like 1,500 of them. That just means that somebody happened to dump 1,500 of them. That's not somebody trying to flip here pretty badly. Now the whips are already selling. We've already sold three, and it's probably been less than 30 seconds. And the dragon claws are selling, which means that the margin hasn't changed yet. It's just that somebody happened to, there's a bunch of people that happened to dump the dragon claws at the price I was buying them for. So that's awesome, and I will check back with you in a moment. Took another, I'd say, 3 minutes, and everything has sold and bought. So we're just gonna cash out on these dragon claws here, the whips, and the minerals we have now. So we're gonna sell those back for at 309 a piece, and wait on those. And I think this will be my last flip that I will commentate. The rest for this episode, I just want to get a few more flips in, just so I have a little more cash that I've made this episode. And already, if that sells for 737K, we'll have made about 500K just from three flips so far. So that's great. One last thing before I get to the profit made in this video and conclude it. I just want to say that I am continuing to fill up my limit on the items previously purchased, like the dragon claws and the living minerals. So don't think that just because you only had enough for, say, six dragon claws like I did, that you should just sell those and move on to the next item. If it's a good margin, go back and buy the rest of the limit if you can. For example, I've already bought one more dragon claw and 2,496 living minerals. Now, bear in mind that these aren't selling, so like I said, I may be being undercut, or the margin may have changed, but we're just going to give that a little more time. If these happen to all buy, or I get bored, then we are going to change the price of this. So, and everything you see in this video, like the staves of light here, these are very good. I'm already getting about a 20K profit on these. So, like, all the items you see me flip in these videos are great items to try, especially for beginners. So go ahead and give that a shot. So this is going to conclude our first episode. Now, as you can see on the screen here, we've got 13.9% profit, which is equivalent to 1.3 mil, almost 1.4 mil gained in half an hour's work, an hour total if you include the time that I was just AFKing. I wasn't even at the computer at the time that the staves of light were selling. or anything like that. So really, it only took about half an hour to make that much money. And so as you can see, even with very small amount of capital I had to work with, you could still make a lot of that money back very quickly through flipping if you know how to do it right. And really the only key to this, there's no magical secret other than, you know, buy low, sell high. But really all you have to do is find items and familiarize yourselves with them. For example, I love Dragon Claws because they give me such great margins all the time. And I do them all the time, so I'm very familiar with them and I know what kind of margins to expect. So they're great for me. You don't always have to find a big variety in the items you're flipping. Find something you like and stick with it, and you'll make gains all the time. So thank you all for watching. Like, comment on this video, and if you have any questions or anything like that, and please subscribe for more.